Hi everyone, this is Joanne Fink for Sikora. And today I'm excited to share a new technique I've been playing with my koi coloring brushes. Those of you who know me know how much I love color, especially rainbow color like my necklace. And I have been making wonderful, beautiful background washes with my koi coloring brushes. And I've pulled out some of my favorite colors, and it's so easy, I'm going to show you how. All you do is just take some koi and put it on a sheet of acetate. These are the sleeves that I use for my prints, and they don't have to go down in any particular color, but I try to stay in one area of the spectrum just so that I don't get too much going on. And I might put a little bit of green over here. So once you have the color down, you have to get a mister bottle, and I have mine handy right here. And all I'm going to do is wet it. I think you can see that the more water you put on it, the more the koi starts to run. And all I do is I'm going to take this and very quickly turn it over, press, and spread the color out. It is different every time and beautiful every time. Then you can take the plastic off, and you have a wonderful watercolor wash. So I've been making these wonderful watercolor washes. I love them so much, I didn't want to write on them. I was afraid of messing them up. So I came up with another idea, and I'm going to share it with you now. The Pigma Calligrapher All Pigma Ink is waterproof. And so I decided that I could write and then just put the wash on top. So let's make a really quick thank you card. I'm using the 3mm Pigma Calligrapher. And I'm just going to write thanks because it's kind of short, but of course I can't resist a flourish. So we'll do thanks with a flourish. I'm going to cut this down into a card and fold it, but I like to do the wash when the card is still flat so I can get the color on the back too. And I've actually prepared yesterday the wash, and the mist will bring the water right back. And so I'm just going to take this and flip it on top and smudge it around. And it's always so exciting because you never really know what you're going to get. But I know that I don't like right there, so I'm just adding some water right there so that I can at least get everything that's near my lettering covered. Okay, so you can leave the plastic on if you want, or pull it off. It will dry faster if you pull it off. So let's look at a few other examples. This is a Mother's Day card that started out printed, designed and then printed onto the watercolor paper, and did the plastic koi coloring brush wash. And because it's hard to read the word mother, I took the metallic jelly rolls, which are opaque, to add some highlights, and the moonlight jelly rolls. And my daughter actually colored this for me. And I love it. All this color is fun, it's beautiful, it's fast, and I'll just say, stays inspired and happy coloring.